So, Steve, what is one of the main mistakes a grower can make as it relates to calcium?
Probably the biggest challenge that I see when people think about calcium is they'll take a soil sample. The results will come back from a laboratory with 1,500 parts per million, 2,000 or 3,000 parts per million calcium on a soil test. And based on that, then the assumption is that, well, there's plenty of calcium that's available to my plant. And this is going to be kind of a long answer, but soil testing measures a number of different fractions in the soil. But the only part of that calcium that's in the soil that the plant can take up is the calcium that's in the soil solution. All the other forms of calcium, the soil lab tests will typically report exchangeable calcium as a percentage of base saturation and then also on a concentration basis. That calcium is important for soil physical properties. If we have a situation where there's sodicity in the soil or excess salinity and so forth, then the soil test for calcium works really good for that analysis. But for looking at calcium nutrition of plants, it is very poor indicator of actual calcium in solution that's available. And the amount of calcium that's, again, reported on a soil test may be thousands of parts per million, but the amount of calcium that's actually present in the soil solution and available to plants is more along the lines of 20 or 30 or maybe 40 or 50 parts per million calcium actually in the soil solution. That's the first mistake. There's two, but that's the first one, is that the soil test is a very poor indicator of the available calcium in terms of plant nutrition.
Is there another test that can be done? How do I find out how much calcium is soluble and available to the plant?
Well, there are, frankly, no real good soil tests to do that, although there are some soil tests which are done in which the soil solution is extracted and the calcium is measured in that soil solution. And that's a better indicator of the calcium that's actually available to our plants. That's still not a perfect test because there's two factors. There's the amount that's in soil solution, and as the plants take up calcium, how quickly is that calcium released from the exchange site and put back into the soil solution? How quickly does that calcium get replaced when the plant takes it up? And the very few tests actually measure that calcium availability in that sort of dynamic root uptake situation. And so those, there is not a real good soil test. As I say, the saturated paste extract is better than the standard one. Now, the second challenge or the second issue that I see is that growers and others will say, oh, well, I've got a calcareous soil. I have free lime in my soil. The pH is above 7. Maybe it's above 7.5. Therefore, I have lots of calcium. And in fact, the same chemistry applies as in the other situation I described, and that is, yes, there's lots of calcium in their soil, probably thousands and thousands of pounds of total calcium in the case of a soil with free lime. But again, that calcium is not available. And there can be 5% free lime, there can be tens of thousands of pounds of calcium, and yet plants will exhibit calcium disorders and deficiencies because that calcium is not available. The soluble calcium is the part that the plants need, and that can be at low concentrations. And as you asked a moment ago, we don't have a very good way to measure that.
So how do I find out whether I need to add calcium?
Well, in some cases, you'll see visual symptoms. The hollow heart, brown center, internal brown spot disorder series of syndrome that you see in potatoes, the blossom end rot of tomatoes and melons and peppers are all manifestations of a copper, or excuse me, calcium deficiency. In some cases, it's simply prudent for a grower to supply soluble calcium during those periods of great demand, simply to prevent it from happening in the absence of a good, reliable soil test. And we've talked all about the soil part, and of course, I'm sure we're going to talk about the plant part in a minute, but calcium is an incredibly important nutrient in the plant.